LA has the highest number of unsheltered homeless anywhere in the nation, with some 42,000 people in our county every night living on the streets. It is altogether unacceptable. Just this last year, the city of Los Angeles allocated nearly $500 million in its budget to house and to serve the most vulnerable among us. Now, as controller, it's my job to make sure that those dollars are actually achieving the result that they should be achieving.
LAHSA's a piece of this overall homeless response system. The city and the county are excellent partners with us in this work, and it's going to take all of us collectively looking at what we're doing, asking questions about are we doing it the right way and how can we do it better.
We are here to make sure that every Angeleno has a place to come home to.
On bridge housing, one of the city's most fundamental priorities, LAHSA not only did not meet its goal, it performed worse than in the prior year, falling from a 32% success rate to just 14%.
Once folks get into those programs, they're staying there and they're waiting there because there's nowhere for them to go, and then the whole system is kind of getting backlogged.
On permanent supportive housing, LAHSA only met 4% of its goal.
What we've seen with some of these amazing influx of resources like Triple H and Measure H is that we had all these resources come in and we tried to build up a system very quickly, and what resulted was a system that's imbalanced. We have a system that's heavy on the outreach and the engagement side, but we haven't proportionately built shelters or housing to move into.
Now again, is this all LAHSA's fault? No, there is plenty of blame to go around for this, and the city needs to do a better job of managing its contract. Having pressure to perform, I think right now that would be a good thing.